Do you like dying at 50? Or 30? Or 0? Well, if you don't, then you most likely won't have a good time playing against a meat brawler who knows his ingredients, especially if this includes advanced knowledge of cheese. If you don't want to embarrass yourself in the next tournament or crew battle by falling for one of Brawler's many cheap tricks, then this video should help you. I'm gonna present Brawler's cheesiest and cheapest tactics and also how to counter them. Each one could cost you an important tournament set, so stick around until the end. Number 1. Downthrower B on platforms. You probably already heard of this, but downthrow into thrust uppercut is a real kill confirm for me Brawler. A lot of characters are rather safe when on the ground, sorry Robin Jigglypuff, but the real threat starts on platforms. On Battlefield and Kalos side platforms, it's still gonna take a while, only killing you around 60%. But never, I repeat, never challenge a Mii Brawler on a top platform of Yoshi's or Battlefield. Or any platform. You might think, but I can just shark under the platform, what's he gonna do about it? Well, there are two things, down air and up tilt. Down air is obvious, it hits through a platform, bounces you up, potentially leading to follow-ups. But at lower percents, the real threat is up tilt. Seriously, this move is pretty much Smash 4 Mario up tilt. It scoops you up from below and perfectly combos into grab, up air or straight up thrupper. So do not challenge a Mii Brawler on platforms if you don't have a really disjointed up air like Link or Shulk. Number 2. Suplex side. Suplex is an unreactable command grab which moves backwards, which by the way can be slightly controlled by the Brawler player. If you don't hit the ground, it will drag you down until a certain point above the blast zone, and you can't mash out at all before that point comes. But once you get released, you actually get a little upwards momentum, and keep your double jump as well as up special. So a good portion on the cast can actually make it back, depending on the blast zones. So if you are one of the lucky characters who can make it back, you will always be safe as long as you don't drop your controller. If you aren't, then keep this in mind and be especially mindful of ledge drop suplex side. You can also use wall jumps to make it back if available. Number 3. The feint jump stomp. Even though it's definitely one of the most underwhelming moves in the game, not having any real knockback growth or combo potential, its angle can still be nasty. Unknowing opponents often go off stage for a run of edge guard, just for the brawler feint jumping back to stage over them. But the real sneaky ones do not go back on stage. They aim for the ledge. They aim for where you will jump, just to step on your head, tumbling down and away from ledge, without a double jump. Even characters who are usually confident in their recovery will have a problem with that. The counterplay? If you do end up in that situation, don't try to rush back to ledge as fast as you can. Notice where the brawler is drifting and time your recovery to avoid the stomp. The hitbox is neither out for long nor very reliable, so as long as you time your jump, you should have no trouble avoiding it. Number 4. Counter throw as a whole. The less known special moves Brawler has are usually just worse than their alternatives. But that doesn't mean they don't have massive amounts of cheese. Counter throw on that matter is a whole dinner plate of cheese, offering a wide variety of weird stinky delicacies, which makes it extremely fun to play. First, the damage and knockback multiplier is only rivaled by Arsene, but compared to most other counters, it launches you backwards. And boy is it fast! As Roy, you might feel safe pressuring ledge with F-tilt. I mean, what's Brawler gonna do? Back throw? Well, he's gonna neutral get up or ledge jump. Counter throw your F-tilt, mess up your DI, and you die at 30. It's active from frame 6 and invulnerable from frame 5, so it's quite useful for that. And please, seriously, please do not try to punish counter throw with a smash attack on reaction. It is such low end lag, the risk of a second counter and dying at zero is much higher than you'd think. Using counter throw as a bait against unknowing opponents is a common thing, so be warned. Number 5. Down air kill power. Counter throw is not the only move capitalizing on DI mix-ups. Mii Brawler's down air is one of the weirdest down airs in the game. The area sweet spot is a pretty standard spike, but the area sour spot sends sideways? Almost at a 90 degree angle? Okay, you might say, that's still not uncommon. Look at Ganondorf for Captain Falcon. Just the eye away from the blast zone and you'll always be fine. Until you look at down air on grounded opponents. In this case, down air doesn't have a spiking hitbox. It just doesn't have one. Instead, it will always send diagonally upwards. Which also kills? Which direction exactly depends on if you get hit on the left or right side. And especially with wrong DI, this will kill. To sum up, DI away from the nearest blast zone or stage and try predicting on which side you're getting hit on stage and DI the other direction. This'll make sure you don't die to random down airs out of shield. And finally, number 6. Flashing Mach Punch invincibility. Very similar to throws, Flashing Mach Punch makes Brawler invincible for the whole move, as long as it's activated. In 1v1s, this is rarely relevant, except for the fact that FMB activates on more than just opponents. It also activates on some items. For example, Pac-Man's Hydrant, Link's Bombs, and even Olimar Pikmin. On things like Isabelle's Down B, it'll only activate partially and then stop. Keep this in mind and don't run blindly into a brawler seemingly exposing himself. Take your time and then go for the punish. And that's it for 6 common Mii Brawler cheese options and how to counter them. There are way more than just these, like all kinds of SAK kills and shot put shenanigans. But I don't like to make long videos, so if you did enjoy the video and want to see a continuation, you can tell me by liking and subscribing. Thank you for watching and until the next video.